My name is Julius Stefan and I'm a projection technician at National Theatre in Prague at Nova Scena. In National Theatre they stopped like rehearsals for now. We are going to the theatre and working over there, but we are doing like maintenance.
There will be some streaming in the next days, like next week there is one streaming program.
Maybe from 8th of June there will be allowed to run theatres, but only like it's not clear, and as far as I heard it's only for 50 people, which is I think not possible for National Theatre to run.
We hope we can get back to normal. We hope we can reopen and then be busy, probably work overtime for the first week or two. It's actually quite funny. I think for the first month or so, people didn't quite realize how long hair salons might be closed for. And now there's sort of like this official date that was announced on television and everything. And it's still a month to go. And so during the last few days, how many people, I don't know, have called, texted, wrote messages on Facebook and sent emails that they all want to be the first person to get their hair cut as soon as we are reopening again. The impact on Prague as a city, and that then I suppose is stronger in the tourist industry. And a lot of people who live here have uncertain futures as far as that goes. It's difficult to judge now what impact it will have on the real estate market with Airbnb and things like that. The international schools. A lot of people, though, that live here and work here in fields that are completely unaffected, they're the ones offering support. They see their income steady and their future secure. And they're the ones who are offering support and saying, you know, we could pay for the next haircut in advance and things. But for hotels and restaurants and things like that at the moment, I think that's probably one of the biggest changes that will take longer to get back to normal, if it ever does.
January and February this year was just when most of the entertainment industry is starting to look towards the summer for what would have been a very busy festival season. And then over the space of 2 weeks from mid-March until the beginning of April, everything evaporated. It's vanished. I think the festival season in Europe for 2020 is basically dead in the water. But things getting back to normal for our business, things are going to change a lot because I think the size of the events are going to be smaller. You're going to see restrictions on gatherings of people, which means anything, I think, over maybe even just 100 people, a couple of hundred people, is not going to be possible. For many years, we've all heard these conversations about virtual clubbing and online events, streamed concerts and things like that. I really think that there's going to be this kind of thing is going to take off. Nothing will replace the experience of being amongst thousands of people at a festival. But I really think that this online world, whether it's entertainment or finance or a myriad other things, is definitely going to come to the fore because of this.
I run a venue called Amazing Chayovna, which usually is quite a vibrant cultural centre. We've got loads of theatre, music, workshop, quizzes and that kind of stuff. There's loads of secret doors and yummy teas and basically a lovely place to be. So our business is usually dependent on running events and having, you know, people buying things. We're planning for several eventualities. We don't know what will happen, but we're trying to be prepared as we can. The best case scenario is we'll open and it's all okay. So we would continue with our theatre and comedy program, and everything would be lovely. Then in a slightly less best case scenario, we'd be able to continue to a certain degree, but we might be limited in the number of people we can have in the theatre. And that might be both from a legal point of view and also from, you know, quite frankly, whether people are wanting to go into spaces with more than 40, 50 people. There wasn't much we could do in terms of financing ourselves, but we decided that the most important thing was going to our roots as a kind of community organization. So we've been raising a lot of money for the charity. The main goal hasn't really been for ourselves, because it's, if I'm brutally honest, it's kind of a drop in the ocean, because you know, we've got very high overheads and rent and all this kind of stuff. And to do that would just mean we're constantly chasing our tail, whereas raising money for the homeless means that we can show that it's possible to do nice things at the moment.
So I work for an American study abroad company. It's called CIS Abroad. We had to cancel the program. We moved very quickly to get our students out. The students all had to leave. They had a one-week window in March. Basically, we're like, you guys need to get out. You need to change your flights and go home. Summer's pretty much a write-off. I don't think the country is going to be open to American students in the summer. But they're optimistic that in the fall, we will be able to get students. I'm unsure, to be honest. It might take a year, maybe two, to get back to the numbers where we were. A student may be able to come here in the fall or in January next year, but chances are they're not going to be able to travel around, you know, every weekend. And that's part of the beauty of studying abroad in Prague, is that most students come because they're in the center of Europe and they can travel to, you know, 20 different countries in 3 months. They won't be able to do that. We have to wait until the Czech authorities lift the ban.
I'm not able to go to the students' houses anymore, which has now led all of the lessons to be online. Well, I say all of the lessons. I have about half of my students, because not all of them wanted to switch to that method. I would say teaching online has its pros and cons. The biggest pro is being able to do it from home and not having to spend so much of your day traveling. Being able to get up straight away, have a cup of coffee, sit down and start is really nice, as your students are kind of doing that with you. I think the biggest impact of it is going to be that a lot more of our schooling could potentially become online, since across the world, people are now doing their schooling online, which is not something we necessarily saw before. I don't think it's a positive thing. I think human interaction and face-to-face contact is very important, and especially when learning and teaching.
We are trying to adjust to the situation in close cooperation with the artists or their agents. I don't think anyone imagined anything like this even happening, maybe except for the people at Wimbledon, who apparently were insured against such a situation. Judging from like the cooperation with other agents and artists and everyone involved, people are hoping this will pass over summer. Of course, it's on everyone's mind that this might not in fact be the case. As has been said, the pandemic might return in the fall, but there's also a very general information that's been linked to any other viruses previously. It might not. So while everyone is, or most people are rebooking for the fall dates or 2021, I would say it's in the back of people's minds that in fact even the fall dates might not happen, but we are working as if they were about to happen, and we hope they will.
From yesterday, markets are allowed again. The point is really to see what is possible to do and think creatively, like come with new solutions. Yeah, I'm sure like some businesses won't hold the pressure, but then other ones can come with the upper hand. Like maybe it can even improve the whole system and how they work. So I guess only time will say. Our original plan was to open from the beginning of April. It's kind of like an open air cafe and a beer garden, but obviously it's not allowed at the moment. So we are, from today, we are opening through a window, through a fence. We decided to do it because at this moment, because also they allowed the farmers markets, which are happening just around the corner from us. So, and people, I guess, were waiting for stuff to happen. So there is a movement of people, which is nice. Those times now, you can only survive if you are flexible, and you have to see what you can do from day to day. We'll be creative with what we can do.